Hello and welcome to the wonderful world of English Language Classroom. This is English Language Classroom for class 7 learners. Today we will read and understand the text of the first lesson, 3 questions. So learners of class 7, ready to read and enjoy, understand the text, 3 questions by Leo Tolstoy, the famous Russian author, who was an apostle of peace and peace activists. He has written a lot of short stories advocating peace. So let's not bother much about the author now, we will come to that later if needed. Today I and Kriti will discuss, read and appreciate, understand the text, 3 questions, the short story slightly abridged by Leo Tolstoy. Fine. Kriti, the title of the short story is 3 questions. Someone is asking some 3 questions to someone else, he is trying to find answers. So let's see the questions first or later. So let's now tell our learners the objectives of this lesson. So here are the objectives. Will you please read out to them?
Sure. Objectives of the lesson. At the end of this lesson, learner will be able to read a variety of texts in English and identify main ideas, characters, sequence of ideas and events and relates with his or her personal experiences. Respond to a variety of questions on familiar and unfamiliar texts verbally and in writing. Use appropriate words to deduce meanings from clues in context while reading a variety of texts.
That means we are going to confine only to understanding of the text.
Yes.
Fine. Come on. Let's see. Someone is asking some 3 questions. Who are those 3 questions? What are those 3 questions? Who are those people to whom he asked the questions? Okay. Now, before we see the questions there, let me ask you something. That is, if you have to ask some important questions to your parents or teachers, someone you trust, believe, respect, what are the 3 questions? Even as a good believer, if you have to ask some 3 questions to God, what would be the questions? Learners, you can also think of those questions and ask someone who is with you. Yeah.
If I have to ask my parents 3 questions, I would ask with respective to the times now we are living in, the pandemic we are seeing, I would ask him that how we can contribute to the community, to the people who are suffering right now. And I will also ask them what is the kind of work we can do on our behalf to improve the society. And I would also ask them that how can we improve the way of living in our place.
Class 7 children, what would they think? You know, Buddha also asked some questions.
Yeah.
What was the question? Why are people suffering?
Yes.
What are the causes of people suffering?
Suffering, yes.
So, you know that what it led to something else. This man had to renounce everything and start preaching, teaching people to make them understand, oh, because you are greedy, you are suffering. So, here is a king. He also has some introspection, reflection. He thinks a lot. So, he asked 3 questions. Here are the 3 questions, learners, on the screen. Let Kriti read out the questions for you.
So, the 3 questions were, what is the right time to begin something? Which people the king should listen to? What is the most important thing for the king to do?
Let me also read the question, what is the right time to begin something? We generally, humans, we wait. My time has not come yet, let me wait.
Yes.
He also has a problem. When should I do this? What is the right time to begin something?
Yes.
Which people should you listen to? Who are the people I can listen to? My ministers or my wife, the queen or the people or the soldiers? So for a ruler, meaning as a human also, I'm a family man or a father or a child, who should I listen to? What is the most important thing for me to do? I'm asking you this question. What is the right time to begin things? I'm not asking you an answer. Think about it. We'll come back to you. Dear learners, let us answer the questions later ourselves. But wait, what made the king ask these questions? Then later the king, how he found answers, or whether he found any answers to this, and what happens to him? Let's summarize. Let's listen to the summary of the story, which you have read. If you have not read, class 7 learners, please read, then listen to the summary again. So here are the summary points, some 12-13. We will alternatively read. She will read one and then I will read the other. Come on, follow it carefully. We are going to ask you some questions. Yeah.
So let's summarize the story. Three questions. Once there was a king who had three questions in his mind. He wished to know the answer to the questions to be a successful ruler.
The three questions are: what is the right time to begin something? Which people should he listen to? What are the most important things for him to do?
The king sent his messengers throughout his kingdom to find the answers for his questions.
The king was not satisfied with the answers. He asked many people. No one was able to give a meaningful answer. So he decided to seek an advice of a hermit.
He visited a hermit in the jungle. The hermit listened to the king but did not speak a word and went on digging.
So the king continued digging the ground till the evening. The hermit was digging. The king took the shawl from him and she started digging.
A man came running towards the hermit and the king, and with the hand on his wounded stomach.
Okay. So he was wounded. He was holding his stomach.
Stomach, yes.
The king cleaned the wound and dressed it twice to control the flow of blood.
In the morning, when the king woke up, he saw the wounded man was seeking for forgiveness.
Okay. In the morning when the king woke up, he found that the wounded man whom he nursed came to the king and touched his feet and said, "Please forgive me." The king went to look for the hermit who was sowing seeds in the beds which they dug the day before.
The king begged the hermit to answer his questions, and hermit replied that the king has already been answered.
The hermit said that the most important time is now. The most important person at the time was the people, we ourselves, they are themselves who are around. The most important thing to do is to do good to others. Now, Kriti, there's a problem. Has the king got the answers?
Not directly he got the answers from the hermit, but yes, okay. It was an indirectly way of answering the question.
Okay. The hermit did not answer him.
Yes.
Okay. Now, let's look at it this way. What was the right time to do? How did the king learn the right time to do?
While he was nursing the man, the wounded man, to back to his life, the hermit answered that it was the right moment, the time was now.
Okay. Then, who are the people he should listen to?
According to the story, the people who the king should be listening to was the people who were around them, the hermit and the wounded man.
Then what was the right thing the king has now realized doing it?
The right thing was that he helped the wounded man and he nursed him to back.
And who was the wounded man?
The wounded man was his arch enemy.
Yes, he wanted to kill the king.
Kill the king, yes.
So this is how the summary of the story. So I'm going to ask you again to read out so that our learners can recall the story meaningfully well. So here is the story. Come on, again read out.
So let's summarize the story again. Once there was a king who had three questions in his mind. He wished to know the answer to the questions to be a successful ruler. The three questions are: what is the right time to begin something? Which people should he listen to? What are the most important things for him to do? The king sent his messengers throughout his kingdom to find the answers for his questions. The king was not satisfied with the answers, so he decided to seek the advice of a hermit. He visited a hermit in the jungle. The hermit listened to the king but did not speak a word and went on digging. The king continued digging the ground till evening. A man came running towards the hermit and the king with the hand on his wounded stomach. The king cleaned the wound and dressed it twice to control the flow of the blood. In the morning, when the king woke up, he saw the wounded man was seeking for forgiveness. The king went to look for the hermit who was sowing seeds in the beds they had dug the day before. The king begged the hermit to answer his questions, and hermit replied that the king has already been answered. The hermit said that the most important time is now. The most important person at that particular moment is we ourselves. The most important thing to do is to do good to others.
Fine. Good reading. Learners, you should be able to now understand the text, the story. There may be some gaps. You have to read the story and understand. Come on. Kriti, there are two questions in multiple choice which appear on the screen. You have to answer it. How did the king seek answers to his three questions? He sent messengers throughout his kingdom and promised a large sum of money as reward. He asked his minister to find answers. He promised that he would give his kingdom to the person who answers three questions. He sent messengers to other countries to seek answers to his questions. What would be?
The correct option would be point A. He sent messengers throughout his kingdom and promised large sum of money as reward.
Okay. The second question, why did the king want to know answers to his three questions? Let me read out the options. He thought that these were important questions to citizens of his kingdom. He thought that he would never fail if he knew answers to three questions. Someone asked him the three questions. The questions appeared in his dreams.
So the correct answer would be point B. He thought that he would never fail if he knew answer to the three questions.
Okay. He wanted that if I know what is the right time to do, who are the right people I should listen to, and what is the thing to do. This is what the king was anxious about it. Now, Kriti, here are the learners. Let's do some sort of puzzle. The summary is there now in jumbled order. I'm going to throw a challenge at Kriti. She will be rearranging it as it appears on your screen. Okay, here are the sentences which have been summarized. Twice we have said. So here is the summary. Now you will have to say they are numbered. You will have to say which one is first, which one will come second. Come on. You may use it as it appears.
So the story in sequence. So now we will rearrange the story. Point number one would be point three. Once there was a king who had three questions in his mind. He wished to know the answer of these questions to be a successful ruler. Point number two will be point number five. The three questions were, what is the right time to begin something? Which people should he listen to? What are the most important things for him to do? Point number three would be point seven. The king sent his messengers throughout his kingdom to find the answer for his questions. Point number four will be point number nine. The king was not satisfied with the answers, so he decided to seek the advice of a hermit. Point number five will be point six. The hermit listened to the king but did not speak and went on digging. Point number six would be point number 11. The king continued digging the ground till evening. Point number 7 would be point number 4. A man came running towards the hermit and the king with the hand on his wounded stomach. Point number 8 would be point 13. The king cleaned the wound and dressed it twice to control the flow of blood. Point number 9 would be point 2. In the morning when the king woke up, he saw the wounded man and he was asking for forgiveness. Point number 10th would be point number 1. The king went to look for the hermit who was sowing seeds in the beds that they have dug the day before. Point number 11 would be point 8. The king begged hermit to answer his questions and hermit replied that you have already been answered. Point number 12 will be point number 10. The hermit said that the most important time is now and the most important person at a particular moment is we ourselves. Lastly, point number 13 would be point 12. The most important thing to do is to do good to others.
Fine. That's what learners. This is also QR coded with the textbook. You can do it by interactive mode. You can drag the point and put it in an order. You can see that. So we have deliberately kept it here so that you know that. Okay, come on. Now, you read your story, understand it, summarize it, or create a subtext. Then the summary is given in jumbled order, you rearrange it. So all what happens in all these, you have to reread the story, you revisit the story.
Yeah.
Come on. So what are the three questions?
The three questions were, what is the right time to do something? Who are the right people at the
moment to listen to?
Listen to. And lastly,
what is a good
what
thing?
Is the
good thing to do?
Good thing to
so
do.
So this we you know most questions are WH questions.
Yeah.
In English.
Yes.
So, WH are how questions. Sometimes this one. Hmm. So I'm going to throw you with a challenge. Very simple, trivial one most likely. WH words are who, what, when, where, how, whose. Many many. They are all questions. So I have got the WH words on one side, then the questions other side, which appears on your screen. You have to answer it by marking it or whatever be. Look at it, whose, why, which, when, what, where, how. Now, you have to find out where it will go, which word will go which. Come on, you may solve it by reading out.
So the first point says, dash is your problem. So it would be point number 5, what is your problem?
Then?
The second question says, dash bottle is this. So this would be point number 1, whose bottle is this?
It's whose bottle.
Whose
yeah,
bottle.
Yeah, then?
Then the third sentence is, dash is your new book. So the answer would be third, which is your new book? The fourth sentence is, how old are you? So this is the?
How.
How.
Okay.
Then it says, dash, are you so nervous? So the WH word would be, why are you so nervous?
Yes.
Then it says, dash is your birthday. This will be, when is your birthday? Lastly, it says, dash, are you from? So it will be, where are you from?
Come on, it appears on your screen with the written one. So where and how they are used, we should know. And this lesson has some clues for that. What, how, this one. How your question is formulated. So, dear learners, we will close this session, this class now with a request and the suggestion to you is you please read the story. We will be dealing with vocabulary. We will discuss vocabulary, the words which appear, some grammar items and also speaking and writing. So, we will have 2 or 3 more parts for this lesson. So, read, reread and check the summary, rearrange the summary. Then we'll come back to you. Thank you for participating. Thank you very much, Kriti.
Thank you,
and the
sir.
Learners, their
Thank
parents,
you,
teachers. Thank you very much.